Meet Christy. She's a 41-year-old woman who wants to start a family more than anything, and she's ready for motherhood now.
Christy, the fact that you froze your eggs, this is going to work out well.
With or without a partner. Lucky for her, we found 15 men who want to skip the dating and go straight to baby making.
That's what's important to her.
But previously, after a slip of the tongue...
Do we all know a song that we can serenade Cindy with to get over here?
Cindy? Who's Cindy?
Alan tried to smooth-talk his way back into Christy's heart.
Somebody mentioned the name Cindy. It was planted in my head.
Okay.
But was not one of the men chosen for a date. And things started to heat up. In both houses...
What was the reaction?
Paint!
Yo, stop talking!
This man. Changing the conversation. Back.
And in a shocking first, Christy sent three men home.
I don't see us starting a family together.
Yep, cool.
No.
I mean, it's not easy to hear that.
Leaving just eight men on their journey to start a family with Christy.
Just another week.
Tonight, through a series of intense drills.
If you could have a boy or a girl first, which would you have?
Oh, that's hard.
Over the top romantic dates. Crazy house drama.
I don't give a what any of these people say.
We'll follow Christy's path to parenthood.
You're great. Go ahead.
So what are you going to do?
I'm not sure.
I'm Kristen Davis. Welcome to Labor of Love.
The energy of eight definitely seems different.
We used to be the bunk of boys downstairs.
What's it like waking up empty room?
Well, now I'm just like the bunk boy. It's just me and Snoots. It's a little scary down there.
I have been saying she likes laughter, she likes lightheartedness, but the clowns of the gang have slowly been vanishing.
To be honest with you, at this point, it's starting to get selective and the competition is getting rather stiff. You know, I'm definitely not just the goofball that some people might think I am. I really do want to start a family, so we got to step up the game.
I'm definitely shocked about Walker, I got to say. I mean, I kind of saw it coming at some stage, but so soon after the date, I was like, oh, wow.
She was really doing her best to be nice and diplomatic, and then she realized it's go time, and she's got to make some tough decisions.
I have not stopped thinking about more time with Christy since the last time with Christy. But I can't fully know if the next date is going to happen, and I'm going to drive myself crazy trying to think about it.
Knowing that there was a few guys left that might not have been taking it as serious, it was reassuring to me. Now those guys are going home and we're all a little more on the chopping block.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say we don't know what to expect.
How you feeling?
Last night was hard. I know they're only gonna get harder, but that felt like a real breakup.
Obviously, you've had relationships mm-hmm. that haven't necessarily worked out how you wanted to, which is true for all
yes.
of us. And was there times where you didn't feel hopeful or where you didn't have an open heart?
Yeah, you know, I mean, I was married briefly and it didn't work out.
Mm.
And suddenly now I was in my late 30s and it felt dark.
I understand.
It really
it's
does
hard.
Because it just, I did think that was the end.
Oh.
It did.
But it wasn't.
Nope.
You can't let that dictate your
yeah.
life, you know? And that's why you're here, and I love that about you.
This is my life, this is what I want, and this
right.
is very real for me.
It's a very real thing.
And life goes on after this. But it makes
Absolutely.
Me, like, even more nervous because...
Of course.
It's, like, so
The
important.
Choices are big. They're big,
yeah.
big choices. I mean, starting a family is one of the biggest decisions that you're ever gonna make.
Kristen is amazing. I feel like she sincerely wants this to work for me. And it really feels great to feel like I have a friend along to help me figure this whole thing out.
You should not have to settle. You're amazing. All of those guys would be incredibly lucky to have you. You
okay.
know, and whatever you feel is what we're gonna do.
Okay.
Each week, we've put the men through parenting drills to test their fatherhood skills.
Yes.
But this week, we're not gonna have a drill because I wanna create a space for you to get to know the eight remaining guys on a deeper level.
Okay, I love it.
Good.
So good.
It's gonna be great.
Let's do it.
We went from 11 to eight guys. Eight is like a whole different thing. And I know that Christy loves a man that can cook and that food is important to her. So I want to give Christy a plate of food, fried chicken, some greens. Like they say, the quickest way to a person's heart is through their stomach.
Is it called greens?
Yeah.
Man.
I'm trying to do it all in one pot.
Man, this is gonna be good, man.
Keith, I just want him to be happy. I know he wants to get married and have a baby. I want him to find that. And I want him to be successful in his career. I think that's plenty. That's good.
Cool time.
You rack, I'll crack.
Like, one of the reasons why I'm here is because my father history. Mm-hmm. My father made his personal priorities number one versus that of the family.
You go on benders, in and out of rehab.
I want to be a better father than he was.
Even though I say I'm ready to be a father, I fear that I'm going to
mess it up.
What if I can't help being my father? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I just don't want to. This stuff is pulling up some emotions that it's taken me 40 years for me to realize I didn't cause a divorce, I didn't cause a strife. But now my concern is that, like, can I be a father? You know, like, is it nurture versus nature? Like, no matter how hard I try, will it still come out?
I think for me, I still see my dad in me in a lot of things, you know, like
the temper.
I know that I wouldn't be that person, but I see it. I think I can push back. I've been responsible to myself my whole life, and I'm ready to be responsible for more people. When I hold my kid for the first time or I walk down the aisle, that's what's gonna put me on the next step. Talking to Stuart, it's helped me put things in perspective. It's helped me realize that I want to be the best father. So I need to make sure that I get time with Christy.
Thank you. I don't know how this ends up, but thank you. Yeah.
There you go.
I decided to take some stew across to Christy. I'm hoping this gesture lets her know that I'm serious about what I want. I know I want to be a father. I know I want to be a husband. And I'd like the chance to connect with her. I'd like the chance to see her.
Sir. What are you doing?
Taking food next door.
Are you delivering?
Hmm.
Alan's going over there.
I'm going over there.
Oh, you are? He's got food in his hand, too. You guys are both doing it.
So I wanted to take fried chicken and some other side dishes to Christy's doorstep because she loves a man who can cook. And then, bam, there's Alan going and dropping a plate. Of course you want to do that. Just tell me that so I'm not the sloppy second guy doing the same damn thing.
That pisses me off. That's called stealing my idea, jumping the line.
I'm sorry, man. You've been definitely talking about that since yesterday.
Yeah, I have.
Did you just cook this by memory?
Yeah. So how have you been?
Better now.
Yeah? Food in your stomach.
I was not expecting Alan to come over, which is amazing because I'm looking for a guy that maybe likes to cook. It kind of is opening the door a little bit for Alan and I, and it does make me want to give him another chance.
I am surprised to see you, I'm not gonna lie.
Are you really?
But it's a pleasant surprise.
Good, I'm glad.
Well, I just thought I wanted to take the opportunity because we haven't had a lot of time together.
Right.
And the little time we've had, I felt a little bit on the back foot.
I think with us, it was more the whole name thing. But obviously, I've kept you here because I'm hoping we have the opportunity to see if we have a potential connection or not.
Everyone in this house has so many great qualities.
But I'm here for the right reasons.
Yeah.
I know you're here looking for a partner. I know you're here looking for a father for your children. I wouldn't be here if that wasn't the case for me as well.
Yeah.
I think this is a really great moment for me and Christy. She's been poised and elegant, and I'm intrigued. I am.
The potential connection would be, you know, based very strongly on whether you finish that stew or not.
So, I'm just gonna send an empty bowl back over to the house. No one's gonna understand except for you.
I have the utmost respect for Keith. Maybe a little more than I do for Alan, to be honest.
It was Keith's thing to do. It's his thing.
100%.
There's an old saying in the wrestling world that if you do get into a scrap with someone in public and you lose, you can't come back to the territory.
You know, for Alan, this might be a mistake.
Thank you so much.
I'll leave this with you.
All right. Thank you, Alan.
And thank you for having me.
Yeah.
I appreciate you taking the time.
Is he done or what? Is he back?
In the Air Force, we work together. So I don't know if it's in me to sit back and not help in a situation where I think I could.
You have fun?
Yeah.
Keith's pretty pissed right now. He's cursing, throwing. I just want to make sure you know what you're walking into. Keith's pretty pissed right now. He's cursing, throwing. He thinks he stole his idea.
He was standing around me watching prepared.
Well, just let him cool down.
Oh, man, he must do what he wants to do. There's a forceful side of Keith, and he is very resistant if things don't go his way.
Hey, Keith. It's Ellen.
Do you want to have a word? I wanted to talk to him about it, but with Keith, I have to be a little more cautious than I probably would be with other people. With hindsight, I probably should have been a little more sensitive to the fact that because I heard you say that you wanted to give her a plate.
Yeah.
In my back of my mind, I figured, okay, you're sorted, you've done your thing,
yeah.
Or you're going to do it another time. I don't know. I just didn't think of, to be honest, I didn't even think of about your thing.
Yeah.
Keith, you know, had a couple angry outbursts. This house is stressful, but he adds to the stress. It's hard enough that we're going through drills, but then you have somebody else who is taking away the energy, the positivity. Truth is, she needs to know, but then nobody wants to be the rat.
I don't give a about playing anybody's games. I'm gonna express myself exactly how I want to express myself.
I am hot. I can pop off. But if I knew that Alan was gonna go before me and do that, there's no way I would have been second. I would have saved it for another day, another time, another context. That's not how I roll.
So from here on out, I don't give a what any of these people say. I'm doing this my way.
The biggest thing that I've learned about myself in this process is that my fire is bigger than I thought it was, and it gets exacerbated by being in a competitive situation with a bunch of men.
Out of here.
I wasn't coming in here to rile up. I appreciate it, man. Thank you.
I think Keith is strong. I think he's determined. I think he has a strong will, just very strong will.
It's time to dig into what your future will look like with some of these men. For today's date, I've left you a little something to wear. Prepare to get your hands dirty. Ooh, okay. So far, I've gone on dates with Matthew, Marcus, Stuart, and Walker. This upcoming week is all about who do I see myself with long term, and who can I see starting a family with?
I have no idea.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I'd rather be in your shoes than me and Keith's shoes of still haven't been on a date and possible elimination.
Yeah.
Like, don't eliminate me without going on a date.
Things are definitely getting more competitive in the house. Alan sort of like slid in there, which definitely upset me. But I'm just trying to go about my day because Christy is what's important.
Someone's knocking on the door.
Knocking?
Oh, come on in.
Hi,
what
Kyle.
Are you wearing? How are you?
What am I wearing?
I don't know. Are you painting today?
To be determined.
All right. You look good. Come on in.
Here we go.
Whoever is going on the date with me today, we're going to get dirty. That's all I know.
Okay.
We get two more dates this week. This is for my date today. And that is Alan.
Hey.
Wow. So.
Yep. All right, Alex.
Have fun.
Oh, wow. I'm a little bit annoyed by that. I'm feeling like a sense of indignity, and I've not had a date, so I'm just worried our connection, whatever there is of it, is starting to drift.
And there is another date tomorrow, and that's going to be with Gary.
Hey.
Gary.
So, Alan and I are gonna head out.
Okay.
Gary, I'll see you tomorrow.
Have fun. Right.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Enjoy.
Bye.
Alan, he needs, quite honestly, if I can be blunt, a lovely girl who can kick his ass. Can I say that?
Okay, this is like a junkyard. Oh, God.
There's a table of stuff.
What is going on? Okay.
Today, you're leaving your single lifestyle behind and moving on to your next chapter.
Using these tools, write words that describe your past you wish to move on from and paint a perfect picture of your future.
Future? Okay. Past.
What in your past are you ready to let go of? Okay, I got one. I'm gonna put this one here.
Deceit. Wow.
I'm starting heavy. Doubt, yeah. I kind of have that one too.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure there's gonna be crossovers a lot.
I got one.
You got some good ones, huh? Control, this is a big one for me.
Yeah, I get
sure.
that. Okay.
As a writer, I don't feel emotion is a sign of weakness. And this date with Christy is a perfect date for me. We both just seem to have come from similar places in the sense that the words that she's writing and the words that I write kind of reflect
a lot of what we both feel.
Destroy our past.
Oh.
Crush our future.
Okay.
Yeah?
In this case, gentlemen first.
Okay, here we go.
I'm so scared. Ah! Oh my God.
Go, come on. Just do it.
Just take care of it, Alan.
We're starting to get that connection. And we're having fun at the same time. And I think when you throw kids into the mix and life gets really busy, it's too easy to stop having fun. What I felt on this date so far is that I can have fun and I can have fun with Alan.
That was good.
My last words to Alan would be to really enjoy this experience and to make the absolute best of it and to have a wonderful time.
I know that his mother loves him.
Ah.
About time for me to start cooking. This is gonna be a sumptuous, decadent, satisfying meal. Chicken on.
Christy and Alan are on this date. I'm gonna go over with a plate of fried chicken with a note on top of it. That looks good and smells good. Drop it off so that when she comes back from Alan, there's a Keith right there.
Dude, everybody's salivating. This chicken is smelling delish, my friend.
You were the right person to be on this date.
I'm glad.
That's what I felt.
I think the things that have come up for me so far, especially now that I've had this time with you, is like how to soldier on as you get one-on-one time with other guys.
We don't need to talk about them.
No.
So after today, do you feel like we have enough things in common?
Hell yeah.
I mean, you hesitated there, Alan. I got a little nervous.
I think it's also been hard because I can see some of the guys, you know, generating some really, you know, interesting feelings for you.
We've developed these connections with one another.
Yeah, they're all gentlemen.
Stuart and Carl, all kind of band of brothers, I guess you can call it.
And as men, we just have to figure it out.
Yeah, but I think we should take it back to us.
Yeah.
And.
So smart.
You know.
So glad you're here.
Because I like where our connection's going.
Yeah, me too.
I do really want this date to just be about Alan and I. I need the father of my children to prioritize family over his bromance with the guys in the house.
And since it's so cold outside,
it is
I think
freezing.
We go to have a nightcap.
Okay. How do we get off this
Let's
thing?
Get off the side.
I think my legs are frozen. I didn't love the date ended on that note. The nightcap gives us a chance to connect in a different way.
Thank you. I appreciate today.
Thank you.
They're back. They're walking.
Good point.
They're in there. They're all whites.
Oh, you look pretty decent. Well, okay,
really?
Your boots
look pretty sexy.
Your boots are a little kind of mucky, but.
Oh, they're going
He's walking up to the steps.
Oh, it's happening.
You got a surprise outside your door.
I do? Is this an awkward moment?
No, you don't read it.
Well, I just want to see.
Wow. Yes. The game is still going.
You got a surprise outside your door.
I do?
Oh, there
he's walking up to the steps.
Oh, it's happening.
Is this an awkward moment?
No, you don't read it.
Well, I just want to see.
Wow.
It would be nice if we could have a drink.
Yeah.
But I'm not comfortable doing it at the house with the other guys around.
Yes!
I'm like, wait, because you...
So never awkward. Mind. Anyway,
anyway
out there.
Alan, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
I had such a great date with you. Alan, spend time focusing on the other guy's feelings rather than building a connection with me, which has really turned me off. You know, I still have a lot of other guys here making me feel special.
Okay. Bye, Alan.
Thank you for the lovely day. It was wonderful.
I agree. Good night. You know, if he was really interested, he should have come in for a drink, but he didn't. He let Keith be the winner tonight.
Is she offended by what I said about the guys? As much as I am here for a certain purpose, that doesn't mean I'm gonna be insensitive to the feelings of others. Because of what happened with Keith, I didn't want them to have to see that.
She knows. I absolutely love this game. She needs people to step up.
Christy deserves the best. She's going to get the best, and it's gonna be a lovely journey.
Did you get my wings?
Yes.
Then I'm good.
There's a true friend right here getting me ready for my date.
I patiently waited my turn to go on a date, and I'm excited. I think that I'll be able to show her what I got. I like to learn. I love music. I like to stand out and be different. I'm confident in me and who I am, and if Christy likes that, great.
Oh, power stands.
Power boom.
Left hip, thumbs in his pocket.
Hi, Gary.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
I like your outfit.
Thanks. Oh, and look at this. Okay, special invitation, get ready to party. Drinks are on me. Being a parent has its serious side, but sometimes it's also fun in games. Please head out back. Kristen.
Okay.
Let's see what's going on.
This is my first time seeing your pad.
Oh, that's right. This is my backyard.
Swing.
Wow. Oh my goodness.
What in the world?
Oh my gosh. This okay. is so cute.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, all right.
Hi. Hi, Kristy. Oh,
hi.
My God. I am so excited to see you. When Kristen told me you could host this party, I was so relieved. You're hosting this party. Thank you so much for doing this. All right. I will see you guys in 3 hours, something like that. You guys got this. Thank you.
I don't even know what to do. Like, they're entertaining.
Just hug me, Gary.
Okay.
Right now, I gotta go into dad mode.
What's up, guys? How you doing?
I wanna make a balloon.
You want me to help you?
Please.
Sure. Let's see if I can make a dog.
I mean, Gary's lots of fun. Do we all think Gary's fun?
Yeah!
Yes! Oh,
yeah.
Oh, Gary!
I draw it on purple.
Did you do that?
Blue, all right.
I would not be stoked to see a bunch of kids arriving on my date. Love kids, but not on a date. Whoa.
I need hugs.
Thank you. Look at this. I got a hat.
Okay.
Oh!
Oh, my God!
The ship is going down.
Oh.
The kids love Gary. It's like flies to honey.
Oh,
they are swarming him.
You tied it down?
Yes, absolutely.
But he's taking it really well.
Together, we worked really well with those kids, and I'm up for the challenge. I think I let that show.
Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. Wow, they really like you, Gary.
I hope from this experience, Gary meets the love of his life. We are excited about more grandkids. Yes, definitely.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay. Hi, Gary.
Hi.
What I learned about you, you're very patient. Kids love you.
I'm genuinely me.
Good.
I'm not going to be good at pretending. You know, like,
I'm not either.
If I'm interested or not. Every time you come around, it is like awesome. You know, it's like good to see you. You light up the room every time.
I feel like you light up the room. Honestly, like I'll tell you, I did notice you right away, and I've actually been really looking forward to us having a date.
Me too.
It feels like it's been a long time coming.
I think that like you're craving to have some fun.
I'm
like,
so
it's like too much seriousness.
Yes,
you can see it.
Yes. Bounce house?
Let's do it. It's like trampoline, but not spit.
There you go. I'm gonna see if I can jump and get up. Nope.
Oh, message. Oh. Good evening, future fathers. It's time for a game. Please go next door and bring Kristy back to play. Hey!
I'll go with you.
Let's go.
One, two.
Yeah.
Hey,
what's
you
up, guys?
We got a message from Kristen Davis, and it said to bring Kristy over for a game.
Okay.
A parenting game.
Okay.
Gary
could come too.
I mean, you can come, but
it's great to see you.
We finally have a minute to bounce around, let loose a little bit, and I'm looking forward to us going to dinner. I'm hoping we get a dinner out of this. And in come Kyle and Stuart. Great. They pull her away.
After you.
Bring the cake. I'm going to bring the cake.
Wait. All
right.
I was left with a 30-pound cake. I really wanted some dinner.
Yeah. We're playing games tonight, people.
May I have the seat?
Yeah, I think so.
Can we switch seats? You want the next one?
Get out of here.
Here.
Take that.
Okay. Gary, scoochy scooch.
Wow.
That way. I'll sit in the middle.
Again, I'm watching everyone jockey for time and jockey for position. But really, I wish it was just her and I. And then the games begin.
Okay, guys, okay. It's game time. There are important questions and meaningful discussions to have before having a child.
Nation. I love this.
Okay, this is gonna be good, you guys.
What you got, KD?
If you could have a boy or a girl first, which would you have?
Oh, that's hard.
Does that mean we're gonna have more than one?
Yes. Okay. One, two, three.
It could quite easily be a girl, but I'll happily take a boy as well.
I do like the idea of a boy first.
I never thought I wouldn't have kids at this point, and so I think I just want a healthy baby.
Yeah, I wanted a girl and then a boy.
If I'm blessed with a child, like, I'm gonna love the hell out of it no matter what.
The gender is not even remotely important to me.
If I don't have a boy, the brooch name goes
pew. If I got the pick, it would be a boy first.
Matt.
Oh, I'm just drawing a dog at this point.
Oh. Matt, you're not getting off the hook.
I don't like this.
Dude, that's not a normal behavior, Matt. Like, I don't see how Christy's looking at that and saying, oh, great, husband, thank you. This is exactly how I want things to be.
All right, next question. What kind of child care will you use?
Start us off.
I mean, I definitely want to have my career still, but, you know, possibly have it more balanced so that I can also spend good time with the family.
Who's going first?
Matt, you're gonna be first.
All right. I said I'd love my child to be raised by my wife as well as our family, parents, et cetera, et cetera.
I'm not willing to give up my career for any of these guys. I'm definitely surprised what I'm learning from Matt, and I'm gonna have to think about this.
So this is what I picture, just like having a sitter for dates, and the rest is us.
The kind that allows for the growth of a healthy, happy child with all the possibilities available to them.
I want to be present for my kids, so work-life balance, make sure I'm home for all the activities I can, as much as possible.
I want to raise my kids. That's one of the main reasons why I waited this long to have any.
You'll be a good dad, Gary.
I'd love to be home with my kids sometimes.
It's good. Yeah.
It's good. Oh, hey.
Good. Hey!
I love their answers on one hand, and on the other, I feel like Matt was not only being quiet, but he's being a poor sport. I think there's some details that need to be worked out still.
I mean, it's very interesting for me to hear what you guys think.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt, but I would love to steal Christy away for just a moment.
Okay.
That's okay with y'all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But when you got a bunch of people you're competing with, it's just hard. And so there's a point where you're kind of like, did I peak too early here? I really like Christy. So Kyle taking her upstairs for who knows how long, that just adds fuel to the fire. I am a little frustrated, but guess it's game on here.
I'm excited.
Come on in.
Oh. Kyle, this is so nice.
So why don't you have a seat? I wanted to show you that you're important to me and you're the reason why I'm here, so.
I mean, I love this.
And I don't want to give you any hints, but it's going to be something fun.
Oh, okay.
But you have to trust me. Do you trust me enough for me to put a blindfold on you?
Yes.
Okay.
I
promise you it'll be fun.
Okay.
Strangely, I do trust Kyle, and he blindfolds me. This just got real.
Let's go. You gotta open up.
Are you close to me?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
All right, ready?
So pure dark chocolate, my favorite.
Ooh, good answer. All right, we're going in.
I love this experience. It's actually pretty romantic.
You gotta bite this one, okay?
Sure.
I gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that is my favorite.
I look in the mirror every day and I'm like, man, there's a lot of guys here that got a lot to offer. Like, do I really fit in here? But I could be the dark horse in this whole thing. So the idea of blindfolding, I felt like it was a little risky, but the chocolate strawberries, God, it was sexy.
This is cool, I love that you created the right moment. It's like so impromptu.
This is just the start of something really special. So I just wanted to put my own destiny in my hands a little bit and just kind of steal you away. And,
I really appreciate this.
Thank you.
When I saw the kids roll up, I was like, man, sucks for Gary. I would not want that whole thing, but it seems like this has been a good day for you.
Yeah, I mean, those kids love me. It was fun.
It would be so hard not to like fall, if like you're in baby making mode, family mode, to see you in that environment.
Oh yeah.
Like that's amazing.
So Christy got to see Gary do very well with kids, and I know that's a very important thing because obviously she wants kids. And so knowing that Elimination Day looms, I need to step my game up.
If I get booted before I get a chance to have a one-on-one, it's gonna be like, you know, a little disheartening.
Do you think she knows you want to spend time with her?
Maybe I got something planned on that. We'll see.
My man.
Everybody's gotten their own little Christy time, and so I'm not gonna get chosen to go on a date quite yet, then I need to step my game up.
Trent is giving me a full-on say anything moment.
I like that.
Oh, I would love to show you a little Texas two-step inside.
Yeah, come on in.
Oh, yes. I mean, I am from Texas. I just decided to pull my boots up tight and go make my own destiny happen. Let's rock this. Okay. Like, this stuff is just easy peasy. Like,
he's teaching her a two-step.
Trent is comedy.
He's doing the work.
Spin moves. You start doing some cable car.
Trent really made an effort tonight. It tells me that he wants to be here and he wants to get to know me.
I like this.
Yeah. And you look absolutely wonderful.
To a degree, Trent was a class clown growing up. His antics would cause a little, get him put in detention for a while. They weren't serious, but he was gonna have fun.
Elimination number four. We've come a long way, gentlemen.
Yes, we have.
Yeah, we have.
About to cross the mountain, halfway point.
Hi, Kristen.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Oh, I love your hair.
Thanks.
Hi. There's Kristen.
Kristen Davis is here.
Going into elimination, you can't help but have some nerves, but I think after yesterday, I have earned myself another week.
Do you feel nervous?
Yeah, you know me. Like, I never love these nights.
Yeah.
You know, it's a hard conversation to have, but I know what I want, and I think getting through this night is getting me closer to the whole reason I'm here.
Yes. Excellent. Okay.
Just because you put them in the we need to talk box doesn't mean they'll be going home. A man could be in that category for good or bad reasons.
That being said, let's look at Trent.
Okay.
Man, this is when it just gets so real.
Who's the first man up?
Hey.
Oh, Trenton.
Trent. Do you feel that he really wants kids?
I do, actually.
Oh, there you go, Trent.
Wow.
That's really slow.
But we are very different in personality.
Mm-hmm.
How would that be on a daily basis?
Uh-oh.
Marcus.
Almost like she's like...
El Cubano Blanco.
It's easy for me with Marcus. You know, we haven't spent a lot of time together, but so far, I really like him. That chemistry, it's there.
Right.
Oh, Morgan. Okay. You're first.
In the safe box.
As first much as I might give it thought,
there you go,
I don't think we'll
completely
all right. Alan. How are you feeling? You got any regrets, Alan?
Alan is like genetically off the charts.
I know.
But this was a big date for Alan and I,
right.
And I really feel like he knew that. And
right.
I feel like he kind of blew it at the end. It was like hot to cold.
I can see some of the guys generating some really interesting feelings for you.
But I think we should take it back to us.
Yeah.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm not sure.
All right, who's going over next?
Gary.
Oh.
Gary? Care Bear.
I could always see Gary being a dad, but maybe not as much as I realized until this date. I'd like to keep dating Gary, yes. I need that romantic date.
Totally.
There you go, there you go.
All right, Stuart, up next.
Stuart is in the same place that I am,
mm-hmm.
and we're on the same page.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Same timeline. I think I move Stuart over to the keep dating.
There it is.
All right.
Congratulations.
There you go.
You're great, go away.
I just got a kiss.
Kyle's on the move.
There we go.
Let's go to Keith.
Okay, Keith.
I'm trying to get out of the friend zone.
He hasn't had a date with me yet.
Good point.
You know, I kind of maybe just need to have a conversation with him.
Good.
Feel it out.
Yeah.
Oh,
Oh, Lord.
Let's look at Matt.
What do you think?
I mean, that's a tough one.
I said I'd love my child to be raised by my wife as well as our family, parents, et cetera, et cetera.
Matt's answer about childcare, it really surprised me.
She's pondering something. Like, she's like...
So there's just a question there for me.
Right. Should we have a little chat?
I think so.
Okay. Is this your final decision?
We're back.
Wow. Oh.
And there's only four of us.
This is crazy that there's only four of us.
Waiting downstairs is amazing because waiting upstairs in elimination sucks.
So it begins. So it begins.
Oh. Hey guys.
Hi.
I don't like elimination. These are starting to feel like real breakups. This is not my favorite night, but I am looking forward to having conversations with each of you for different reasons. So, Trent, I'm gonna start with you.
Yeah.
Okay? So we're gonna head in there.
Show enough.
Matt, I mean, Trent Leaf is a sign, okay, she's honing in on fatherhood, husband, that kind of thing. Yep. Not just, I want some good people around just to make me feel good about myself.
Right.
I appreciate that you're really fun. I love that you say what you really think. I think my question is it too over the top?
I wish we'd go on a one-on-one date before I get booted, just because I think I can easily flip the script and become much more of a serious person.
But you are very different from me. What you're not realizing is I actually really like that about you. I really do, Trent.
Don't. Give me.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I thought you were about to tell me to give me the boot.
Man, I'm feeling great. So I get kind of stereotyped as like a big old goofball, but you know, there is a serious side of me that wants the family, wants the kids. It's time to put my best foot forward and show her that I'm the man for the job.
Oh, who's it gonna be?
Hey!
Oh, wow.
I guess we're playing tennis after all.
I knew from that first day, like, you were one of the good ones. Since then, I've, you know, been feeling like we haven't been able to connect. I see you as someone who really wants to be a great partner, who will be a great dad. But I think you stopped taking this seriously, and that's a big deal to me. And we have different ideas about how we want to parent.
Regardless of what you're about to say, I'm glad I got to know Christy Joy.
You're gonna be such an amazing dad. I just don't think it's worth
it. Okay, okay. Have a great life, okay?
You too. Okay, bye.
I know she's gonna be happy. I know she's not gonna settle for anything but the best. And she deserves that.
I wish you the best life that you could have. 100%. God bless you.
I'll have feelings for her for a while. But I just want to hear your voice. I'm one
number away from calling you. I said I was through, but I'm done. You know, we both deserve to have everything that we want. And he wasn't the right one for me. I'm leaving and not coming back. Okay, have a seat.
You first. Alan spent more time with Christy and Keith.
So she's got to know him almost better than any of us.
Right. I think Alan's coming back.
Yeah, he might be.
I had a great time on our date.
I'm glad.
And I felt a connection starting. I felt excited.
No, me too.
I think that's really how I felt. And I felt my heart sink immediately when your first thought was, I'm worried about the other guys. Because I felt like there was a door that had been opened and it got closed.
So let me clarify a few things. The door was opened,
yeah.
And it was left open.
Mm-hmm.
But that being said, my nature is empathy and compassion, and I just didn't have it in me to do it in front of guys who I know for a fact have redeveloped feelings for you. At the end of the day, I just wanted to be sensitive to the people around me and not...
Except for me. there's a time in my life where I would keep wanting to have that connection with you. But it's like, I'm 41 years old. I have a great life. And I don't want to have to convince you to want to get to know me. And for that reason, I don't see us starting a family together.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. It was a good opportunity to be here, get to know you. And you've got some great guys downstairs.
Bye.
Bye.
20-year-old Christy would be chasing Alan, but 41-year-old Christy is here for a very specific reason. To not only find the man that I'm attracted to, but to find the man that I can see myself starting a family with.
You know, I look back at our date and I think it all went perfectly well. I absolutely stand by the decision I made. I stand by what I said to her. I hope whatever choice she makes, it's the right one for her.
Keith?
Thank you.
I think Keith is more of a question mark.
I'm curious about Keith. So is he coming back or not?
Well, we have to remember, Christy hasn't seen the Keith that we've seen.
You know, people always say the best relationships have a foundation of friendship, but time is running out. And it's time for us to, you know, come together in a way that feels a little bit more intimate.
Like, I know we haven't had a date.
Yeah.
But I do appreciate these things that you've done.
Yeah.
And so I have to agree with you. I think we need to keep dating. I'm feeling good about this.
All right, right on.
So, yeah, join the guys downstairs.
Ultimately, I kept Keith over Alan because Keith has done the very thing I've asked these men to do from the beginning, and that's show me that they want to be here.
Open the door. Who's gonna be?
I knew it.
I said it's gonna be Keith.
It's good to see you guys.
Keith has a temper that Christy hasn't seen yet. I think it would be a turnoff for her.
Alan's gone.
Alan's
what?
Gone.
What?
Wow.
Do you
need
somebody to walk you?
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay. I think I'm gonna make everyone really frustrated, but
it's not my fault.
Everybody's sending messages. Everybody's going on dates. I asked to walk her home because I just want there to be something that's her and I's, and I would walk more than across the driveway for her.
Just so you know, like, you're the one that made this real for me. I'm just saying.
Dude, we kissed again, and we didn't have a date. Like,
I feel like my relationship with Christy, especially after the little date we had, is a little more passionate. But I think right now, Marcus is my biggest competition in the house.
Next time on Labor of Love.
Your water has now broken, and we're at the hospital.
My innards just came out.
In my life, I'm also fire. I like to challenge people.
That is not a personality that I gel well with.
Made in Georgia.